Wallach was still complaining about his works-built 935, but the other Porsches had something to worry about as well. The Capri was in a class of its own here. Despite Winkelhock being away first, Ludwig just drove around the outside and never had to worry about any Porsche at all. Well, maybe perhaps three times, exactly the amount of times he had to lap teammate Soldek, who drove the second Kremer car for the occasion, since his Capri was lost in a fiery accident at the Nürburgring while testing. It was his birthday, and his dad bought him the seat for 27,000 Dutch marks. Winkelhock took care of the task to keep the spectators awake when he came in complaining about vibrations. On his way to the pits, he wouldn't let John Fitzpatrick by, and the Englishman took the inside on the Sachs curve, and they touched, but both of them could continue. Winkelhock, after his pit stop, still landed on the podium. Howard Groves and Walter Brunn should have been ahead of Heyer on the grid, but Brunn couldn't use his soft Dunlops since his car had problems in final practice, while Howard Groves in the 1978 car had throttle linkage problems. For 15 laps, a train ran through the Motodrome, consisting of Harald Ertl, Harald Gross, Klaus Niedwitz, and Hans Heyer, as well as Hans Stuck, who attacked and passed and seemed to be having fun. But in lap 16, Harald Ertl nudged teammate Klaus Niedwitz at the entrance of Sachs Corner, and the latter had to pit with a puncture. Ertl broke away now, Stuck and Gross unable to keep up, while Heyer dropped back to score points in calculated Niki Lauda style, which in later years would be called Alain Prost style. When Gross retired with bearing failure, the race seemed over, but not so. When Ertl was held up by backmarkers, Stuck closed in rapidly, but then met Niedwitz, who was one lap down, but cut in front of Stuck and braked. Angry faces at Schnitzer, happy faces at Zach Speed. Meanwhile, a little bit of drama in the Rennsport trophy. Christian Danner was accused of using tyres which were too wide in practice, but with narrower ones he was even faster and lapped his adversaries at least once in the race. Muller Jr.'s victory in the small division was a little less convincing, since Seltzer retired and Koenig was pushed into the grass by Muller Jr. Harald Gross was added to the Schnitzer team as some sort of joker for a last-ditch effort for Hans Stuck to win the championship. GS Lancia didn't hesitate and brought a second car for Eddie Cheever. The American held back at the start to block Gross, but the man from Essen didn't like that at all, and even before the start line he already attacked and got in between the Lancias. He touched Heyer, Cheever countered, and in the end both Gross and Heyer had a puncture. Heyer could start all over again, not for the first time this season, and in the end, a fourth place and 10 points was the reward. It could have been 12, since Ertl, who had been in the pits for 10 laps, started a fight with his teammate Niedwitz, nearly taking him out. But the D&W Capri held on and won the race, ahead of Stuck and Brunn. Division 1 was less exciting. Wallach had a minimal chance at the title, though when he took the lead in lap 6, some teams got their calculators out. But the calculators could be put away quickly as Wallach came in with tire troubles. Stommelin took over, but an oil leak in the interior of the cockpit of his car ruined his chances. So Winkelhock won ahead of Ludwig, who had been pushed off the track by Wallach early in the race and had to gain a lot of lost ground. Ludwig would finish second, meaning that only Stuck could challenge Heyer in the final race of the season, but that's a story for another time.
44,3, aber wie gesagt, das alles zählte nicht mehr. Hans Heyer ist der neue deutsche Meister.